Hello everyone. So this tutorial video is only for a visualization of a particular function. So here we can see that this function is basically a function root over x square plus 1. So this is the curve representing that, and we are trying to approximate the area under the curve in the interval 0 and 1. So, and this a denotes the number of sub intervals. So this is the left sum, as we have seen in the earlier two videos. So as the number of sub intervals increases, you can see that the area which we are calculating, the Riemann sum, that is actually approaching the actual value of the integration fx dx in 0 and 1. So that is the area under the curve bounded by x axis. As you can see, as I am increasing the number of sub intervals, we are getting closer and closer to that value. And as the number of subinterval decreases, we can see the error increases. That is, we are going further away from the area under the curve. So at a equal to 4, you can see there are some errors. So this will give the area as 1.099 something. So this is the left sum, left Riemann sum. Now if we consider the right Riemann sum for 4 subintervals, you can see we are getting more areas, so we are getting further away from the area under the curve, and you are getting the value 1.203 and so on. And as we are approaching, so as we are increasing the number of sub intervals, we are approaching the actual values. That is the main point of this theorem. So let me show you the visualization. This is for one sub interval itself, so you get the area 1.414. for a equal to 5, you can see that comes towards 1.19. for a equal to 16, it's come 1.16. a equal to 30, 1.15. a equal to 48, 1.1521. so we are coming closer to the actual values. So a equal to 88, it is giving 1.1501, and a equal to 100, it is giving us 1.14. yeah, so we can see the animation now, how we are approaching to the actual value. This is for the right sum or the upper sum. Now for the left sum, if we can see, yeah, this is for the left sum. And suppose for a equal to 10, we are seeing both the sum. So you can see the below things are for left sum, and the upper things, the which are coming from the upward direction of this curve, that is the upper sum of the upper Riemann sum. So for a equal to 10, we can see these two together here. Thank you.